Good afternoon, everyone. Let's start this session. So in this session, we will learn how to draw the engineering curves. So basically, this engineering curve, it is the part of module 1. So for your syllabus, there are only 3 engineering curves. So first one is the cycloid, second is involute, and third is the helix. Okay. So we will see how to draw this one by one. So first we will see what is meaning of cycloid. So cycloid curve is generated by a fixed point on the circumference of a circle when the circle rolls on a straight line or on another circle without slip. So cycloid is basically locus drawn through successive positions of a same point on the circumference of a circle as circle rolls on a straight line or on a another circle. Okay. So let us see with one animation how the cycloid curve is developed. So in this animation, you can see the cycloid curve. So this is one circle. It is rolling on this horizontal line. So we have selected one point on the circumference of circle in order to trace the cycloid curve. Okay. So you can see here this arrow. So this is the point for which we will draw the cycloid. So as the circle is rolling on this horizontal line without slipping, the path traced by this single point, so that curve is called as a cycloid curve. Okay. So just observe how the cycloid is generated. So this circle is rolling without any slipping on this horizontal line. Okay, so this complete curve is called as a cycloid curve. So right now, we have selected this point. So curve is starting from this location. So if we select the starting position of the curve, that is, if we select this point as a starting point, that is a point of contact between this circumference and this horizontal line, then this like cycloid, it will start from this location. Okay, so it will start from this location, then it will move towards rightward side. Okay, like this. So if this is the starting point of the curve, then this is the cycloid. Okay. So we can draw this cycloid for one complete revolution of the circle or for two complete revolution of the circle. Okay. So what is the application of this cycloid curve? So where basically it is used? So it is used to draw the gear profiles. Okay, so that means the gears which are used in the machines or automobiles, their profile is generated with the help of the cycloid curves. So you can see here the different gear pairs which are used in the machines. So in the last image, so this is the gear profile. That means if you take a single tooth of this gear, okay, so this small portion, then its profile that means its shape. So it is generated with the help of the cycloid curve. So you can see here, this is the half portion. So this half portion, so it is generated with the help of one form of cycloid curve that is called as epicycloid, and the remaining half portion, so this portion, so it is generated with the help of another curve. So it is a subtype of the cycloid curve. This is called as a hypocycloid. Okay. So cycloid, it has two types. One is the epicycloid and second is the hypocycloid. So epicycloid is generated with the help of a rolling circle when the circle is rolling on another circle. Okay. So when the circle is rolling outside the so outside this circle having the larger diameter, okay, then the epicycloid curve is generated. And if the circle is rolling inside this circle, then the curve generated, this is called as a hypocycloid. Okay, so we will see this, how to draw this curve in the manual drafting. So we can note down this problem. Draw a cycloid curve generated by a circle rolling on a straight horizontal line. The starting point is contact of a circle with the horizontal line. Okay. So take the circle diameter as a 5 cm. And you should draw the cycloid for one complete revolution. Okay. So your first step is draw the circle with the diameter that is equal to 5 cm, that is 50 mm. Okay. Then divide this circle into 12 equal parts. So basically, we will divide the complete one revolution, that is complete rolling motion of that circle on that straight line, into 12 subparts. Okay. And for each subpart, we will find out the location of that point so that we can trace the complete cycloid. So divide this into 12 parts. Okay. Now from this point, that is from this bottom point, draw one horizontal line. Okay. Now on this horizontal line, you take the distance that is equal to the perimeter of the circle. Okay, that is equal to 2 pi r. And then divide this complete distance 2 pi r into 12 equal parts. Okay. Then draw one horizontal line from this center point of the circle. So we should divide this. So this total distance I have taken as a 2 pi r, that is equal to perimeter. Okay. Now each subdivision, draw one vertical line. So intersection of this vertical line with this horizontal line, so it will give the position of this center point of the circle after 1/12 of revolution. Okay, so as we are dividing this circle into 12 equal parts, so as the circle is rolling, its center point, it will change the position after specific time interval. Okay, so after 1/12 revolution, this point, it will shift the position, and this is the new position of that point. Okay, so after again 1/12 revolution, this point, it will shift the position, and this is the new position. Okay, so similarly, this center point, it will pass through the successive points on this horizontal line. Okay, and finally, after one complete revolution, this center point, it will take this position. Okay, so you can give the name to all these centers. So you can divide this line into 12 parts. So this is okay. So similarly, you can give the names from C1 to C12. Okay, now the point that we have selected to draw the cycloid, that is the starting point of cycloid. So it is the contact point between the circumference and this horizontal line. Okay, that means the curve, it will start from this point, then it will move upward, and at the same time it will move on the right side. Okay, so once you divide this into 12 equal parts, you can give the name C1 to C12. Now draw the horizontal line from these points. Okay, that is a segment on the circumference. So in this way, you can give the name. So starting from right side, give the name each segment 1 to 11, and P is the starting point for that cycloid. So this is the actual rolling motion. So this is the point for which we have to draw the cycloid. So after one complete revolution, so this is the final position of the same point. Okay, so your cycloid, it will start from this point and it will end at this location. Okay, so during this rolling, this center point of the circle, it will take the successive positions on this horizontal line, and finally this point, it will shift to the extreme right side after one complete revolution. Okay, so if you observe the position of this point during this rolling motion, so initially it moves in the upward direction, it will move to the top position, and after half revolution, it will move to the downward side. Okay, you can observe here. So we have to trace all these points on its path. Okay, and then we can draw the free hand curve so that we will get complete cycloid. So in order to get the successive position of this point, we have drawn these horizontal lines from each segment of the circle. So let us see how to find out its position of this point. So after 1/12th revolution, as the circle is rolling on the right side, after 1/12th of revolution, this center point, it will shift to the position which is C1, okay, and this point it will slightly move on the right side, and at the same time it will move in the upward direction. Okay, so if this is the point, that is the starting point, let us take this as a P. Just consider x and y axis. So as the circle is rolling, this point it will move on this side. Okay, that means it will move towards right side. At the same time, it is moving towards upward. Okay. So after 1/12th revolution, this point it will shift to another location. Okay. So this is suppose P point. So this is the P1 point. Okay. After 1/12th of revolution. Again, after 1/12th of revolution. So this is the next position. So this is the P2. So similarly, we have to find out the position P1 of the point P after 1/12th of revolution. So we have selected the center from C to C1. Now take the distance in your compass that is equal to the radius. So here, radius is equal to 25 mm. So take the distance 25 mm in the compass. Select C1 as a center. Okay, take C1 as a center. That is, fix your compass at C1 and draw the arc on this line. Okay, that is line passing. I think this is 11, and this is 1. Okay, so line which is passing through 1 and 11, draw the arc. So you will get one intersection point. So that point is nothing but the position P1. So you can see here. Take distance R25. And draw this arc. Okay, so this position is nothing but the point P1. So this is the P1. So again, after 1/12th of revolution. Okay, that means circle is continuously in the rolling motion. Okay, so initially it is at C, center will be at C1. Again, center will change the position, it will move to the C2. So this is the position from C1 to C2. Take the same radius, that is 25 mm. Now this P1, it will move to the location P2. Okay. Now this location of P2, it will be on the line which is passing through this point. So this is 10 and this is 0.2. So the line which is passing through 10 and 2, draw the arc on this line by taking C2 as a center. So by selecting this C2 as a center, draw this arc. Okay. So this intersection, it is nothing but the point P2. So after this, take the next position of the center. So this is the position C3. So similarly, mark all the positions from C1 to C12. Okay. Now when C3 is the center, we should draw the arc on the line which is just above this line. Okay. So that means this is the line which is passing through point 9 and this point is 3. Okay. So on this line, draw the arc with the same radius by taking C3 as a center. Okay. So suppose this is the position of that arc. Okay, so this point, so this is P1, P1, P2, this will be P3. Then from C4, draw this arc on the line which is passing through point 8 and point 4. Okay, so this is the point P4, this is P3, this is P4. So P4 is when C4 is the center. Okay. Now take C5 as a center and then draw the arc on the line which is passing through 7 and 5. So when C5 is the center, you should draw the arc on this line. So you will get this point as a P5. Now when C6 is the center, so at the point C6, this is the half revolution. So that means this point, so it will be shifted to opposite side. Okay. So when C6 is the center, you should get the arc which is exactly tangent. So this is the point which is a P6. Now after C6, center position is C7. Now draw this arc. So basically this remaining cycloid, it will be symmetric about the P6 point. So this point is point C1. This is C8. So for C8 as a center, you will get the arc on this line and this is the point P8. For C9, draw the arc on this center line only. So this is P9 point. For C10, draw the arc on this line which is passing through 10 and 2. So this point, it will be P10. For C11, draw this arc. So this is the P11 and this is the last point which is a P12 when C12 is the center. Okay. So in this way, you will get the different points as the circle is rolling on the right side. Now through all these points from P1 to P12, draw a smooth curve. Okay, so this is complete cycloid for one revolution. Okay, I hope this procedure is clear. How to draw this cycloid for one complete revolution of the circle. So here the starting point of the cycloid is contact point between the circumference and the horizontal tangent line. Now note down the second problem. So in this problem, a thin circular disc of 50 mm diameter is allowed to roll without slipping from upper edge of a sloping plank, which is inclined at 50 degree with the horizontal. Draw the curve traced by the point on the circumference of the disc. Okay, so here we will draw the cycloid curve for one complete revolution. So if you compare the cycloid for the last problem, then in that problem, the circle was rolling on the horizontal straight line. And here the condition given is circle diameter is 50 mm, is allowed to roll without slipping from upper edge of a sloping plank, okay, which is inclined at 15 degree. With the horizontal plane. Okay, so here we will draw one line which is inclined at 15 degree. Okay, now starting point is upper edge. So this is the starting point. Okay, you should take this complete length from point B to A. Okay. So this total length will be equal to the circumference or periphery of the circle, that is equal to 2 pi r. And remaining procedure is same, just we have to start the cycloid from the left side. Okay, that means circle is rolling in this direction, it is rolling downward. So this is the starting point and this is the last one. So let us see how to draw this on the drawing paper. So I will explain with the help of CAD software. You follow the same steps in the manual drafting.